In this video, we want to talk about the factors that affect the propagation velocity of nerve impulses along the axon. And that's going to depend largely upon what we refer to as cable properties of those axons. These are the passive electrical properties. And the key ones we want to focus on are the resistance internally, right? The resistance to current flow along the cytoplasm, and the resistance to current flow across the membrane and out of the cell. And those two are indicated by these arrows here, right? So this is current flow along the axon, right? And there's a resistance to current flow in that direction. And of course, this one would be current flow out of the cell, and it would be opposed by, resisted by, resistance of the membrane to current flow. Now, if we look in A, right, we see that a small axon has relatively high internal resistance. This has to do with fewer ions being available to sort of convey that electrotonic current down the cytoplasm. Resistance to the membrane is relatively low, which means we have a great deal of leak of current out of the cell. And so overall, right, we boost our voltage change with our voltage-gated channels, or sodium channels opening here. But then we get very rapid decay, right? Our slope here is very steep. We get rapid decay, and our membrane potential dissipates quickly with distance. That means we need to regenerate new action potentials very close together along the axon. And that slows propagation because the ion fluxes through the voltage-gated channels is actually a fairly slow process, right? And so we have to keep regenerating numerous times this electrotonic current. If we come down to B, we can see that we have a little bit better scenario in terms of velocity, propagation of velocity, and that's because our axon is larger in diameter. And what this does is it reduces this internal resistance. So notice my arrows here just got a little bit longer, a little bit bigger, right? And so our rate of decay of that electrotonic current is slower, which means it travels farther down the axon before needing to be boosted, right, by these voltage-gated channels. And so it travels farther. It opens voltage-gated channels a little bit farther down to be boosted. It'll still wane because we still have some leak here, right? Our resistance of our membrane is still relatively low, right? We still have a good bit of leak there. But the resistance inside went down, which means our current flow is better along the length of the axon, increasing our propagation velocity. So large axons are faster axons. In C, we have the fastest possible scenario, and that's where we add myelin. Now, you might say, well, why don't we have myelin everywhere? Because we'd make all axons fast. And the answer probably lies in the fact that myelin is energetically expensive, right? We have to generate these cells, numerous repeating layers of myelin around these around the axon. And so it's energetically expensive. So we really only add it to axons that need to propagate signals quite rapidly. Well, let's see what it does, though, right? Wrapping these multiple layers of membrane around the axon, what it does is it increases the electrical resistance across the membrane. And so our electrotonic current is now best down the axon in these large myelinated axons, right? It's going to travel the farthest and therefore the fastest, right? Our decay rate of our voltage change is very slow. We get way down here. Now, it still is decaying, so we still need the boost, right? So we do need voltage-gated channels at the nodes to boost our signal again, but then our signal is going to wane very slowly, make it to the next node where it gets boosted again. And so our myelinated large axons will be the fastest propagating, again, because they have low RI and high RM, right? If we draw that out as the length constant, lambda is proportional to RM over RI. Right, and so lambda, the answer over here, our length constant is large. If the resistance of the membrane is high, add myelin, and the resistance internally is low, make the axon larger.